Daily. This is the same struggle.
I don't know, Asha. We wake up before sunrise, leave our cars, children just to wait here. And when does the water come, Asha?
Don't know, Sita.
Along with praying, we should put some
Then what to do?
As an engineer, we have some responsibilities. We have been working on something that might help us. You all know the situation is getting worse every day. The groundwater level is depleting and rain is not available anymore. But we have technology on our side.
Technology? How can it help us, Jaya?
We have been studying a technique called rainwater harvesting. If we collect and store rainwater efficiently, we can have that water all year round. We have also been working with our team on a low-cost water purification system and solar energy. This can make even the dirtiest water safe to drink.
It's true. Rain is unpredictable, but we can maximize what little we get. And with solar power purifier, we can use water from lake, pond, even wastewater after it's been treated.
So, not only we can have enough water to drink, but also to grow our crops efficiently?
Yes, absolutely.
By combining these technologies, rainwater harvesting and solar purification, we can ensure our village is water secure.
But will it help to us?
We barely get any rain here.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh. You dear, you are not understanding anything.
Huh? Then yes, friendly, come on, tell me.
Please, both of you stop it. This evening, Panchayat is going to head. My friend and I are going to source some ideas over there. So, you are there, you will get full idea.
Okay, then let's go. Again, you guys started. Stop it.
Then let's go. Come on, let's.
The village panchayat, led by the enthusiastic but slightly eccentric Gaudu Sarpanch. Today, we are gathered here to discuss the solution proposed by Usha and Jaya, who are the engineers. So, we are here with the Sarpanch. With his help of his assistant, his confusion turned into the fascination. This is a mixture of amidst serious discussions and the comedic moments too. Let's have a look. Water and make it safe to drink.
So what is this solar energy?
I hear about it. Solar energy and sunlight.
Yes sir, it purifies uses sunlight to kill the bacteria and other impurities. See, this is a small model of solar power purifier. This is a solar panel. Solar panel is connected to the low cost purifier. And low cost purifier is connected to the river or pond. In this way, we can purify even the dirtiest water.
I think this is
like a magic machine.
Well, sir, it's not magic, but it's technology.
I want to see this in our village. Okay, we decided. I will be going to insert it in our village.
This is modular and it is perfect for a community like ours. sun will power it, and you don't have to worry about the cost. We will get fresh water daily. Yes, Amira, I know, but we will grow millet crops instead of staple crops so that the millet crops can consume only less water. So it will be very easy for us.
Oh, really? But how could it make a difference?
It will make a lot of difference. Staple crops consume very, very much water as compared to the millet crops. So, and millet crops are also very healthy.
It will work. We have already started setting up the first unit. With your help, we can have it running in just a few weeks.
Oh, really? We are not in the fear anymore now. We are not selected in the cooking or in the drinking for us and for the animals.
Yes, Amira. This is the start of a new chapter for us. You will have enough water to live, to grow crops, to thrive.
Dr. Hassan and Dr. Zoya, whatever you need, we will do it for you and for our future. Yes, for our future.
You have both been so strong. This community has shown resilience beyond measure. Now it's time to rebuild, to start fresh.
Okay, let's get started.
So, before moving to next scene, let us take a small interval. We hope you enjoy this read. Now, in the parched land of Africa, a village struggles to survive. In this drama, there are many main characters. The main characters are Mama Amina, a wise elder, and Baba Musa, a desperate farmer. And the next one is Zuri, a bright optimist who believes in the power of technology. And the next character is the daughter of Mama Amina, Lisa. She is a young inventor of crazy innovations. And behind the other hand, the next character is Dr. Dominic, a scientist with innovative ideas. Now let's see the well will run with water or not. So let's get started.
Sometimes you hope something most unexpected ways.
machine that will pull water from the air. I saw it in the comic book. If we can't get water from the ground, why not pull it from the sky?
If it were that easy, we would not be in this mess. Huh? But go ahead, try it out. May the clouds be pity upon us.
Don't worry, Lisa. I really admire your creativity. But I think you need more improvement, my dear. I thought it would work, but the air here is so dry. It's extremely moisture to collect atmosphere here.
Good, good, my daughter. Your heart is in the right place. But it is not easy to find. It is very difficult to find water in this vast land.
What is this? The lakes and rivers near us are drying. We have tried everything possible. We dig and the resistance, dipping, everything we need. But what it works? I need a solution soon here.
Good afternoon, everyone. I hear we are in some serious need of hydration.
Dr. Tamli, we were glad you are here. We need your expertise more than ever.
I have bought something that might help you. It's called atmospheric water generator. This pulls the water from the air and cools down it and condenses the evaporation. It's like Lisa's idea, but with a bit more technology. Not at all, Lisa. In fact, it's a brilliant concept. We just need to do is apply the right technology. And we don't stand here. We have also been working on solar-powered irrigation systems. These systems use the very little water we have for supplying it directly to the roots of the plants. Exactly. The solar power collects the energy which powers pumps that directly to the roots of the plant. And with the help of the atmospheric water generator, we can extract the water directly from the air.
My mother sent me the story of a time where the rivers are flowed freely and the rains come in the clockwork. But now our land is too thirsty and so far our chisels.
Dr. Damini, can your machines really bring back water from our land?
Well, Mama Amina, I don't promise miracles, but I believe in the power of science and the resilience of the people. With the help of you all, we can do it. We can start to rebuild.
So, you were saying that I could be the first water engineer of our village. Maybe I could ever invent the super water extractor with your help, Dr. Ramini.
Who's know, Lisa? Maybe one day people will be telling a story about a girl who saved our village with her crazy invention.
Yes, yes. We must honor their feelings by doing everything. But we are together very strong. Anyhow, we will find one way.
And you are not alone. We all will bring in the technology. And with the help of you all, we can do it. But it's your spirit, your determination that will work. But we will start to rebuild.
Yes.